Right, I'm going to show you a math card trick. It is a genuine maths trick. There's no sleight of hand, there's no YouTubery. There's not a sneaky edit or anything like that. Everything you see is the whole trick, there's nothing else. And also because it is a maths card trick, it will involve a lot of tedious counting. So here this is going to work. I have a normal deck of cards, there are all 52 cards in there. I'm going to look through. What I'm going to do is pick one of the cards and memorize where it is in the deck. So I'm going to pick one of these cards, and then what I'm going to do is count how many cards are on top of it, and I'm going to remember both the card I'm thinking of and the number of cards above it. Okay, got it. Okay, so I'm remembering one card in this deck, and I'm remembering where it is. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to broadcast the number of cards into Brady's mind, right? So I'm thinking of a number of cards. I'm going to send that number into his mind. He's going to tell me that number that I've sent to him, and then we're going to count off that many, and the next one will be the card I'm remembering. Skeptical people may say, you're just going to change your mind to whatever the card happens to be. So I'm going to write down, in fact, I will show, how can we do this? Okay, so we're going to kick Brady out. He's going to leave the room. Just briefly, over here, this is my prediction. So I'm going to predict this card here. Okay, that one there, cool. And then if I fold this up, hang on a second. Okay, you can't see that. Actually, I'll put it down there. Okay, cool, yep, you're good. So I wrote it down on a piece of paper, I awkwardly scrunched it up with one hand and I put it down there. But everyone has seen the card I'm thinking of. So now, when I send this number into your mind, right, and you see the number, I'm going to count off that many cards and bam, the next one will be the one that I wrote down on that piece of paper. Okay, and in case it goes wrong, I reserve the right to do this up to twice. At that point, we'll just call it off. Okay, so here we go. Here comes the number, Brady. What is it?
12.
Okay, so I'm going to take off 12 cards. The next one will be the one that I wrote down. Here we go. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, next card. Next card is the King of Spades. I did not write down the King of Spades. There's not the card. I'm very sorry, I didn't write that down. But I'll tell you what, we'll try again. We'll do one more time. So ready, okay, ready? What's the number? Here it comes.
15
this time. Okay, here we go, 15. Are you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, ready? Here we go. Did I write down the Four of Spades? I did not write down the Four of Spades. What I actually wrote down was the Eight of Diamonds. And you might think that this trick is a bit of a bust. You tried to guess the number twice. You said 12 the first time, you said 15 the second time. It wasn't at either of those positions. It turns out, I mean, just putting it, giving you one number in your mind would be slightly impressive. Sending you two numbers would be even better. If you changed your mind even slightly on either of those numbers, the difference wouldn't have been three. You actually had to take three cards off, and then it's the next one. And again, if you hadn't said 12 and 15, we wouldn't have got three. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. The next card is the Eight of Diamonds. Okay. And now I just look smug for a while. So that's my trick where I send numbers into someone's brain. Yeah, okay, so it's always, to be fair, every time you do the trick, you have to deal it out twice. You have to put it back together each time, and it always ends up being the difference between the two numbers. And obviously, this started off in a very particular position, and it was a position where, by dealing it out twice, it always ends up at the difference. There is one slight tweak depending on if the second number the person says was bigger or smaller than the first number. And so you have to do something slightly different in that case. But if you get a pack of cards and you have a bit of a play with it, you'll be able to work it out reasonably quickly. Okay, if you're still here, I'll explain most of how the trick works. And so what I did when I looked through the cards, I was looking through them, but to be honest, I wasn't counting or anything. I was just looking to see what the top card was. And as we know, it was the Eight of Diamonds. So you look through, see what the top card is. That's the card you write down. So now, when you start sending numbers into someone's brain, you've got to pay attention to what happens to the top card. So Brady, the first number he said was 12. And so when I start counting 12, the top card off is the chosen card, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And when you count cards off into a pile, you're reversing their order. Because what was the top card is now the bottom card of this pile. And a lot of maths magic tricks use the fact that you reverse cards when you deal them out. So when I put them back together, the Eight of Diamonds will now become the 12th card from the top. In fact, whatever number your volunteer says first, it will end up being that card from the top. And so now, Brady picked 15, which was a bigger number. And so as I count to 15, first of all, I have to count up to 12 to get to 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And as the 12th card comes off, that was our original Eight of Diamonds, because we've just reversed 12 again. And then you count 13, 14, 15. So in fact, I've got to put three more cards on top to go from 12 to 15. I have to put the difference of the two numbers on top to go from the first number to get to the second number. When I put them back together now, all I have to do is take off those three. So I take off the difference, 1, 2, 3, and the next card is our friend the Eight of Diamonds again. And so no matter what two numbers they say, as long as the first one's smaller, the first time you deal, it puts it into that position. The second time you deal, it reverses it back to the original order, and then you put the extra ones on top. Once you take those off, it's right there. If you're still watching, then you want to work out what happens when the second number is smaller than the first number. So I'll show you again. So we'll pretend Brady did the same thing, but he said 15 first, then 12 second. Okay, and so there's the Eight of Diamonds is still on top. So first of all, 15. Okay, so 1, there's the 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I put it back on top. Now the trouble is, if the second number is smaller, you're not going to get back to the chosen card. You're just not going to get far enough. But what you will do is you'll take off, well, let's say 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then obviously you're going to do the thing with, oh no, that's not it, it didn't work, boo-hoo. The trick now is instead of putting these back on top, put them underneath. Because now you've put it into the 15th position, which was the first big number. You've then taken away that 12. In fact, it's still the difference between the two numbers with one slight subtle change. Instead of taking off that many cards and then the next one, you take off that many cards and it's the last one. I'll show you. So in this case, I would say, oh, you pick 15 and 12, the difference is 3. Wow, it's actually the third card. Here we go, ready? 1, 2, 3. And there it is, it's the third card. And so it's still the difference, but all you need to do is make sure, instead of counting off all of them first and then revealing it, you count them off and turn over the last one. Okay. What if they pick the same number twice? If they pick the same number twice, then what you need to do is, I mean, obviously you can play off the fact that they're very, very insistent that that's the number. And you say, look, okay, you seem very insistent. I mean, in fact, you're right. That is the number I was sending. Something just went wrong the first time, so I doubted myself. But you know what? It probably is that number. Then you count them off again. And the important thing is this time you count off that many cards and then you turn over the last one you're counting. So I'll show you very quickly. So 8 was the top. Let's say Brady said 12 the first time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh no, I got it wrong. I'll put them back on again. And then he's like, no, I insist, it's definitely 12. You go, okay, well, we'll check. Maybe it's just the 12th card. Maybe that's the number I'm trying to send you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, it is. Wow, how about that? Oh, it still worked. So there you are. That's what you do if they say the same number twice.
Here we go. Here's my homemade lottery balls. I'm going to give them a little shake. And I'm looking away because I really don't want to cheat here. So, you know, looking away, got one hand in there, I'm pulling out a ball, and it's number 2.
Yes, there is one more option. What if they say 1 or 0 at the very, very beginning? And if they say 1 or 0 at the very, very beginning, this is perfect, right? And this has actually happened to me. Twice now, someone said 1, it's the top card. And so what you do is you go, really, the top card? You really think I'll just put it? And they go, yeah, no, I'm absolutely certain. You go, well, good, I'm glad you're certain, because it is the top card. And then their brain blows up. It's absolutely amazing. And I think that is all the options.